All right. My name is Tecoy Porter, and I'm the proud pastor of the Genesis Church, South Sacramento. I grew up in Minneapolis, Minnesota. I just came back from there, from the George Floyd Memorial, helping Reverend Al Sharpton and the National Action Network. We lead the Sacramento chapter of that. We thank Betty for this opportunity. And we want to thank Black Lives Matters for this opportunity. You're doing a great job. Come on, let's give it up for Black Lives Matter. We are at a turning point in our nation with a generation of people who are ready to stand together. We're marching together. Now we're going to pray together. And I hope in November you vote together to eradicate the virus of racism in our government, business, policing, policies, education, yes, even our faith. We all have a role to play. And today my challenge is for you to do your part. You're doing it right now in protests. You're doing it right now in marching. But we gotta keep on doing it. Turn to your neighbors and say, neighbor, keep on doing it.
Keep on doing it.
Everybody gotta do your part. And for everyone that's been asking how can you be involved, jump in. Do your part. Don't be silent. Don't wait for permission to speak up. We all have a place and a purpose. And if we all play our part, I believe we will start seeing progress. If we all play our part, one day we'll be able to say to everything racist in our country, to get your knee off our neck and let us breathe. Let us pray. God of our weary ears, God of our silent tears, you brought us thus far all this way. You've seen our actions, and you've heard our cries for fairness and justice. Lord, we are asking for healing in our land. We need healing from COVID-19 and all manner of illness and disease that's impacting us. Lord, we ask that you would heal us from the sin of racism and the virus of white supremacy. We call it out right now. We confess our wrong. We ask for forgiveness as we seek justice. Lord, protect our children. Protect Black lives. Because it's our house. It's our house that's on fire. Lord, we're asking that you bless us because our people who are suffering disproportionately economically, socially, academically, and in our health. Lord, heal our land. We've come today praying for the families of George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, Sandra Bland, Eric Garner, Philando Castile, Stephon Clark, along with the countless numbers of those names who are unknown but have lost loved ones by racist violence and police brutality. Lord, comfort them from in their grief. And Lord, we don't want to go back to normal. Normal wasn't working. Normal wasn't good. Normal was racist behavior. Normal was police killing our boys and girls. So Lord, instead, let us be better. Help us to be better neighbors, better people, better cities, and a better nation. Change us so that we may love our neighbors and be our brothers and sisters keeper. We pray for justice and for the healing of our nation. And we pray for all these things in Jesus' name. I pray. Let the church say amen. Yeah.